Hello everyone, this video is to explain about LangGraph. Already we discussed about LangChain. Okay, we used LangChain in agent, that example for storing the context history, right? And similarly we used LangChain for our RAG project also, right? Retrieval augmented generation, that pipeline. I've used LangChain. Okay, LangChain, it's open source software, right? So that the same company is providing LangGraph. LangGraph also open source. Okay, here you can see the details from their website, langchain.com/langgraph. Here you can get even they provided a free course about LangGraph. They're very useful. Okay, the first thing is LangChain is for workflow. It's linear things, right? One by one, for very simple workflow, LangChain is useful. In case of LangGraph, it is for multi-agent system. Okay, multi-agent system involving node kind of knowledge graph, that kind of relations. Okay, and it has a lot of unique features, say for example that LangGraph libraries are allowing us to implement a human in the loop, that concept, very easily. Say for example in the screen we are seeing, right, here in the workflow, it's asking approve, reject, that kind of thing. Okay, so based on the person's human's feedback, it will be continuing further. Okay, so that implementation is very easy. If you check that code, you can understand it is very easy to implement human in the loop. And multi-agent system, it is very important concept in case of LangGraph. So these days we are hearing about agentic AI, right? So in case of simple AI agents, it will be specific for a particular task. Okay, but in case of agentic AI, we can just fix the goal, set the goal, and that multi-agent systems with that agentic AI concept, they will be able to work on achieving that goal, by creating multiple agents and coordinating with the proper orchestration and keeping the memory state. Okay, so that case, implementing that workflow, LangGraph will be more useful. Okay, and for human in the loop implementation, for implementing multi-agent systems, LangGraph will be useful. And one more thing is that memory maintenance. Okay, so maintaining memory, memory in the sense, there are different kinds of memory. Okay, so for example in our agent, that example, we noticed symbol memory, context history, right? So we tried both things. Individually we created a history, that list, Python list, and we loaded that information, and then we retrieved that, okay, whenever we record. Okay, and in the LangChain example, we used a LangChain class, buffer memory something, right? So that was doing all the things, record for doing context history maintenance. Okay, that is for simple context history maintenance. But in case of memory, it is it's a huge concept. Okay, even in human life, our memory is different things. Say for example, if you are planning to copy one password or something, just you will be remembering temporarily, right? You'll be say for example, if you want to enter OTP, you'll be just reading that, and you'll be just temporarily keeping in your mind, and you'll be entering that, and once after that, within few minutes, you'll be forgetting that. You won't be remembering that OTP numbers. Okay, but in case of your mobile number, you'll be keeping it for long time. Okay, so there are short-term memory, long-term memory, and episodic memory, that kind of stuff. Say for example, you'll be associating your memories with places and time period, when you are certain age period, you'll be remembering when I was 12 years old, I remember that, right? Or when I visited that particular city, I remembered these things, I had that experience, you will be remembering those things. So there are different kinds of memories. So In case of agentic AI system also, we can implement different kinds of memory system. So for implementing that thing, LangGraph libraries will be very useful. LangGraph has many different kinds of classes to achieve that. So and steaming that feature, for that also that LangGraph is having options. Okay. So basically, LangGraph is useful for maintaining state. Okay, that is the core concept in this agentic AI system. So LangGraph, I will be showing with one simple demo. Okay. So first of all, we should know the, suppose if you are not familiar with knowledge graph, you should be knowing that. I will be explaining that. Okay, here in the lang chain, they provided that sample node here. I will be opening it here. Okay, so here the node is like the graph, knowledge graph. It is like nodes and edges. Nodes are like these components, right? Maybe persons, maybe places. Okay. They are called as nodes generally. Okay, but in case of LangGraph in the agentic AI system, the one agent is one node, like that we can assume. Okay, here just to understand that graph concept, we need to look into this simple example here. Here Mona Lisa is painted by Da Vinci, right? Da Vinci is a node, Mona Lisa is a node painted by, that is a relation or edge. Okay, and similarly here this person James likes Mona Lisa, right? James is a node, Mona Lisa is a node, likes is a relations edge. Okay, that is likes is edge. And there are different things. There is Da Vinci painted Mona Lisa, which is liked by James, who is friend of Lily. Okay, James is born on particular date, okay, has lived in this there are different kinds of relationship associations, right? So in case of LangGraph, we have to maintain understand two things: nodes and edges. So these are all nodes, person, places, that are all nodes. Edges are relations. So similarly, in LangGraph also, here these are all node, step on step to that things, and edges, step one to step two, right? That is a relation, right? So LangGraph is useful for creating agentic AI systems with multiple agents with orchestration and stuff. Okay, and it is easy to implement state memory system, different memory systems. Okay, let us see one simple example. I already set up the prerequisites exporting the LLM API keys and activating environment, virtual environment, and installing the LangGraph libraries or things. Okay, now I'm just running. So here we are importing a state graph. That is the core concept of LangGraph, right? And runnable lambda, that concept is lang chain, you might have learned, right? The concept of lang chain is that plug and play of components, right? So to do that, for chaining purpose, it should be compatible inputs and output, right? Suppose if you are doing it a Lego bridge, it should be connecting with each other. In that case, suppose if one component is giving output as integer and another one is giving output as string, and it may not be compatible with some other components, right? So we have to convert it into a standard thing. So that is what runnable, that concept. For that we are using runnable lambda. It will be converting anything into a runnable format. Okay, so for that we are importing that one. And it is obviously for LLM. I am using Google Gemini. Okay, so we are creating that LLM, pursuing the model. Okay, and temperature is right? Temperature, if it is high, one, then it will be giving randomness. It will be useful creativeness, but keeping less temperature will be giving the reliability. For factual things, it will be useful. Okay, and we imported the record libraries. We set up the LLM, and then we are creating two agents. One agent is a research agent, and the second agent is summary agent. Research agent purpose is getting answer from LLM, okay, for our question. Okay, It is very simple thing, and as I said, state is important. The state can be like a simple dictionary. Here we are creating with a state graph, we are creating everything, right? Here it is like a simple dictionary, in case of if you want, you can make it as a pedantic base model, okay? But basically it's a dictionary, a key value pair, okay? So it's like say for example, if there are different information like here, right? In the agent it is info, we are loading that into the state, and here summary we are loading into that state, okay? So state is like, as I said, dictionary, so we can add different key value pair, but in case of particular key it's getting new value, it will be updated, okay? So it's like maintaining state, okay? So basically that LLM, that all the relations are stateless, it's a stateless thing, right? So to keep this state, we have to maintain in some way. So and for that purpose, it is important for memory future. We can assume simply like that, okay? We created two agents. One agent is a research agent, another one is summary agent, okay? And as I said, using runnable lambda, we can convert into like a standard thing, okay? So, and we are creating state graph here, okay? And we are adding nodes to that graph, and we are adding edges. So basically the overall thing is we have to create state graph, and we need to add nodes, and then we need to add edges, okay? So here we are creating state graph, and then we are adding node, research node and summarize node, okay? And in case of adding node is like we already created one function, right? So on that function, we are using the help of runnable lambda, we are converting it to like a standard format and then adding as a node, okay? So once after adding the node, we have to like add edges, okay? So edges, we have to start with starting point, right? So set the entry point at search, the first one, and then next one is the research is connected to summarize. So that is one edge, okay? Connecting research to summarize, and then connecting the summarize into end. So that is another edge. So we are adding two edges, and then finally we are compiling the graph, okay? So then we have to use this compiled output, okay? So after that, for any kind of invoking other purpose, we need to use this app, right? That output of compile, okay? So we can just see the graph also. LangGraph is providing that feature. Let me show that in the output, okay? And we are invoking and giving the output, printing the output, okay? Here I already started running, right? Let us see. So okay, see here that draw ASCII, right? So it's drawing in this command line itself, okay? Otherwise if you are using Google Colab thing, you will be seeing something like a graphical thing like this one, okay? It will be like something similar to this one, and here you are seeing the graph using draw ASCII. That is start node, and start is the end, and these are the nodes, research, summarize, okay? So basically that research output of research will be given to summarize as the input, and the summarize output is giving us end, okay? So it's all about graph, okay? And here the output you can see, right? Info is like it is the info is added by research agent output, right? So here it's giving more detailed output about LangGraph, and the summary, like we are seeing the summary, right? It's like brief summary of that output, okay? So ultimately we created a multi-agent system basically. So one agent is responsible for getting an answer for the question, it's a research agent, and another agent is for summarizing the answer, okay? With the combination of that thing, ultimately we are getting the short answer for the question, okay? It's just for learning purpose. We have a lot of real world applications. If you go through LangSit, they provide a lot of examples, okay? You can go through that. It's as I said, they are providing free video tutorial with a lot of good information, and I believe there will be a lot of demand for LangGraph because it is easy to use, right? These days that LLM based agentic AI systems and multi-agent systems are becoming very key thing, okay. And so for doing complex things like without frameworks, doing them will be a bit difficult. LangGraph is good framework, open source and free, okay. But they are having platforms also that are like paid, okay. So hosting things also they are having, like if you go through that you can get more details here, the products, frameworks and the platforms also there, LangGraph platform, okay. LangSmith is for logging purpose, okay. So we have to get the LangSmith API and we need to use in our coding, and automatically that debugging or tracking will be happening. And if we are facing any difficulties, we can go through that logs and we can easily troubleshoot the errors, okay. It is a very simple LangGraph based multi-agent system, okay. We are importing the record library classes and we are setting up the LLM using Gemini model, and we are creating two agents, one is for researching, another is for summarizing, okay. And here the state, that is important thing, okay. The state, we are here we are setting the state, right, here that info, here that we are using that info. So that is the relation between instead of passing the things, instead of doing that, we are just putting the value in the state and another agent can take that information from that state itself, okay. That be, for this simple example, it may be looking like it is unnecessary like that, but in a multi-agent system, very complex, even the loop, a lot of complexities we can add, okay. In that case, it is very difficult to keep on passing the values, so it is better to put it in a state and take it from the state, okay. That concept, state concept, is core for agentic AI systems. That is why LangGraph is also following the same thing. Similar to LangGraph, other frameworks also there, Crew AI, that kind of stuff, but it seems LangGraph is growing very fast. They keep on updating it. Initially I thought when I started using LangChain, I was thinking libraries were changing very quickly, right? So I thought why we need to unnecessarily take care of those things. Simply we can directly use the LLMs and vector databases in our code directly without using LangChain, that I was thinking. But in case of this multi-agent system, the complexities, if it is increasing, means manual coding, other things are really becoming very tough one. So in that case, obviously we have to start using some kinds of framework. So LangGraph may be a good choice, okay. Okay, thanks for watching this video.